Hello guys, so today we're going to be testing a GTX 650. I had purchased it off of eBay with a lot of other units that it came with. This one, I wasn't sure if it was like legitimate. I figured it was more like a GTS 450. Yeah, GTS 450. Something quite a bit lower spec'd. I had seen some of the GTX 650s. They had came with a mini HDMI, so I kind of assumed they were all like that, but I was told that they're not all mini HDMI, so that's good. We got it. It is recognizing as the 650. We'll have to check these clocks here, just check, see if those match up. But yeah, let's get it rocking. We're gonna try Heaven Bench first. Okay, go medium. This shouldn't have too much of a di too much difficulty doing this, but we'll see. Yeah, I have a lot of cards to try out. I had even got the what is it? The GTX 730, 4 GB model. But we're just having issues. A little bit of issues with getting it started. It might not work. Okay, that looks about right. That's pretty good. We got graphics clock 1058, memory clock 2500. Let me see what it should be right now. I'll check. That's accurate. All right, so we have a GTX 650. All right, so we're running on medium quality. Let's quit out of this. We're getting 32 FPS, as you can see. Okay, so there's our Heaven Bench, first benchmark. All right, so we're going to be doing the just the 3D Mark bench for this. Kind of try to get some numbers for it. This one, I'm pretty sure it's an off-brand GPU. I also have the EVGA model, which is probably your best bet, but the cooler on this looks pretty cool, so that's good. So we got through DirectX 9. So with this card, I remember my buddy had given it to me out back in high school. It was never that great of a card. It's pretty low end. He had bought the 750 Ti. And he was mentioning it's very good, great wattage. It wasn't too powerful. It wasn't too energy. It was energy efficient. That's why he liked it so much, and it did a decent job. His card he actually gave me for free. But a lot of the games I had tested were not like top notch. Just for me, it wasn't an enjoyable card back in 2014, 2015. Maybe even, I'm thinking 2014 sounds more about right, but back then it wasn't a very enjoyable card to have, in my opinion. But I'm pretty sure I had the 6850 as well at that time, so it's kind of hard to compare the two, because you could tell one is like flagship, and one's probably low end or middle range, mid range. Near, I guess the 6850 was like near flagship, probably not the top because they had the 6870. And then they had the 6950, the 6970 just after. This was a good find. I found 11 cards, different GPUs for 90. So 90 US, so that was pretty good. There we go. These NVIDIA cards, though, they're so well, like the drivers are so well made for them. Tell me if you guys had any like bad experiences. So far, it's like pretty decent. That was pretty bad, though. That's pretty bad. That performed worse than the 730 Yeston. That's pretty bad. So, it did make it through the test, but that's pretty bad. Oh my goodness. All right. I'm gonna mark it down. But yeah, we're looking at a 3D Mark score of 678 for the GTX 650. I'm kind of gonna be comparing a lot of these models because most of the models, it's just weird how the market works. They're all like $30. I don't know why they always pick like 30, 50. They don't really even like pay attention to what the actual performance of these cards are. Like you can get a 6950 for the same price as you can get this card, or maybe like, you know, $10 more or whatever. But there's really no, oh, well, this card, it's an old card, so they kind of price it that way, I guess, you know. But yeah, this is not a good scoring card. Definitely not good. But let's see. Let's give it an extra chance. We're gonna run. I'm gonna pick out different games. We're gonna run Fallout and see how Fallout runs. Ultra high quality. I mean, that's what it wants. Let's give it a shot. Yeah, so I'm gonna be testing a lot of cards. With this tech channel, we have so much we could do with it, really. Okay. Not all that bad, honestly. It's really not all that bad. With New Vegas, I love New Vegas. You could tell, like, I'll play it often. But, when you aim, it's very, the
All
weapon is
mine.
always moving left to right, you know, it's jacking all over the place, so it's hard to get a clear shot. What should be like easy gun downs end up being a missed shot, which
You're
is
mine.
pretty rough. Okay, well, we're averaging at 60, it's looking pretty good. It's nothing too crazy. Okay. Alright, so the 650 could play Fallout New Vegas. I'm gonna do Black Ops. This won't be too in-depth with this video, but I'm just glad I can get a few of these benchmarks out. We got the Heaven Bench was around 32 FPS. Alright, so we're gonna be testing out Call of Duty Black Ops 1. It was one of the better titles that I really enjoyed. Something that even back then the graphics was insane. In my opinion, it was the best graphics. To this day, I still feel like that those graphics really hold up. And if you use the right card with maybe some modifications, you might be able to make it look almost brand new. It's a beautiful title. Great game all around. Even using this GTX 650, you could still enjoy the game itself, which is nice because this is a really old card. It's still an old game, but sometimes it's meant to be played on cards that were being made at that time. Now, in this case, Black Ops came out in around 2010. This card came out in 2012. So, that being said, it's pretty close. Nvidia, I'm sure they had Black Ops in mind for playing with this card. So you're looking at a perfectly optimized card for Call of Duty for Black Ops. Just like anything, you want to run games that were optimized for the card itself. The card, whenever it came out, it's gonna really affect how the game plays, in my opinion. Like, I got a lot of older cards that just they'll play the old games as they should run. But you try to run a newer game, it's not gonna be good. You try to run games even older than that, it might not play well because it's just not optimized for. They just don't assume that you're going to be playing these really old games on this card. This card is perfect. You're in the right timeline. You're playing the perfect game. Everything's beautiful, as it should be ran. Overall, I think I'm not the best at the game, but it's a great game, and the 650 plays it well. Alrighty, so just to recap, we tested the GTX 650, tested Black Ops, we had tested Heaven Bench, we had done 3D Mark. Overall, it was a decent card. It's a little low performing. Played Black Ops really well. Fallout played good, decent. Would I recommend this card now? Probably not, but if you're gonna play those titles from that time period, it's a perfect card for that. Overall, thank you for watching. Please like and subscribe. If you want to see more content, definitely leave a like. Down at the bottom, I'll have my Robinhood and my First Trade. They give out a free stock for anyone who creates an account with them. But again, thanks again for everyone for watching. Everyone enjoy the rest of your week.